Welcome to How to Pass Your Grade 1 Music Theory Exam. Whichever exam board your music tutor has recommended for you, you're going to need some basic essential knowledge. Remember, this is knowledge you can use in the future for your own arranging and composing. Okay, now we're going to have a look at something called the Great Stave. Now, originally, the Great Stave had 11 lines and was fiendishly difficult to read or write on. Very confusing, 11 lines. So, sensibly, musicians started to eliminate the middle line and leave us with two sets of five lines, a treble stave and a bass stave, which we read simultaneously if we're going to play the piano or keyboard. So we put our treble clef, remember that from the previous lesson, our treble clef sits here on the second line up, and the bass clef on the second line down with its two buttons. And we've got right hand music and left hand music. And a nice little mind trick to remember this is the treble clef represents mid to higher notes. So we place it on the second line up, and the bass clef represents mid to low notes. So we place it on the second line down. Up note, treble, down, bass. And here, right in the middle, when we need it, we draw a little line here. I'll just pick up the black for you. And that's where we place the note on the missing centre line, and that's our dear friend middle C, the one most of us learn in lesson one of piano or keyboard, middle C. And it's called middle C because it is in the middle of the great stave. If you look carefully at your piano or keyboard, it is not exactly in the middle. It is usually to the left of the middle. The middle refers to being in between the treble and the bass stave. So middle C, in the middle of the great stave. Easy to read, easy to write.